Good evening, everyone. This is Roll Pilot here, and we are getting ready for an SPL league match happening in a couple of minutes here between Murder Hornets and Emperor's New Group. Let's catch you up first on where we are in the league action as they're getting ready. They're picking their sides right now. Last night, if you missed it, Murder Hornets had split with Serum Squadron 1-1 in a very thrilling contest. In game one, it was literally came down to the wire as Zarup led with one kill to go, but the Murder Hornets tied it up with a critical kill on myself, and then picked up a kill on Thanatos within the first 2 minutes of overtime to take game one. When game two, Zarup came back with a dominating performance in order to secure 3 points from that game. And earlier, Murder Hornets have also played Emperor's Hammer, who they have had, who they won both games by convincing margins to get 6 points out of that. So right now, 1AW is playing their, I think, second match. Yes, their second match after having lost to league defending champions Cutie Ties here, in very convincing fashion. So they are looking for their first points of the season. So let me check to see where they're at here as we get ready for this critical dogfight between these two teams, the Murder Hornets being an old guard team here, and 1AW being new to the league. Looks like Han, Dire Host. Looks like Murder Hornets will host versus Empire, and they will go to Esselis. So just waiting for the information here, so that way we can jump on in and start covering this match. Trying to get the room info here. Not sure what's going on. Find out from these guys. Custom. Nope, cancel. Password, please. Sorry, everyone. Give me a second here as we wait for the password to come in. So, the Murder Hornets again are an old guard team. They, I've been looking much better this season, and they're hoping to pull second here. Don't believe that's the wrong. Nope. Back here. This right password. It is right password. There we go. Okay. We're gonna load in here. Go to. There we go. Okay, they are loading in now. So coming in tonight for the Murder Hornet, Starfire, Veggie Booty, Spaceman, Roxy. I'm assuming Fuzzy or Mustang will be here. From 1AW, Flabbergasted goes to 12 coming in now. Murder Hornets are hosting, so they'll be Empire first. Interested to see how they line up. Last night they ran a Bomber, a Reaper, and a Defender with two TIE Fighters. I wonder if they're going to adjust here to see if they're going to try and limit their damage, or if they're going to try and get those quick slays with Defender. Black Light, Google Stays, Psy Warrior also coming in. This is the 1AW crew. We're waiting one more from Murder Hornets before we get this started. Let me just make sure of the modifiers. Cool. Oh, Flabbergasted is. Hey, Fuzzy, how you doing? Flabbergasted is flying for Murder. No, he's got this wrong. He needs to fix this. Captain Obvious is flying for Murder. Flabbergasted is flying for 1AW. There we go. They're fixing it now. Okay. Do I have the name right? No, I got it backwards. Let me fix this really quick as well for you guys. So this isn't confusing. ZH. And this is the Murder Hornets. Okay. So they are lined up. They're ready to go. I already gave them my green light. So they can go when they are ready. So, from 1AW, I'm interested to see if they're going to go with ICT Wyomings or not. Give me a second. Thank you. I don't know why that happened. Yeah, save. Thank you. I've already given them my green light, so hopefully they just go. It's 1AW, thank you. Man, I got ready for this like 20 minutes ago. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I apologize, everyone. Did not spend some time to get ready for this match. I could have just agreed to do this on the fly. So, still waiting for them to launch. And there we go. Okay. So, from the Murder Hornets. Murder Hornets, so they're still picking out their lineup here. Let's go see. So, from 1AW, they will come out with 1 A-Wing and 4 X-Wings, it looks like, so far. From the Murder Hornets, they are looking up. They might be following along with last night's strategy from Sarah. Nope, they're going to go with 1 Bomber, an Interceptor, and 3 TIE Fighters. So, looks like they'll go with a pretty, pretty standard lineup for a league play here. Let me just check on these guys again. Oh, they're going to go with 2 A-Wings and 3 X-Wings. Interesting call, interesting call. Let's see how this goes. The 2 A-Wings will be required to do some annoyance and basically natting on the opponents, whereas the X-Wings have to come in for Slay, and then from the opponent side of the Empire, definitely the TIE Fighters are going to be the ones putting the dunks to get the shields down, whereas the Bomber and the Interceptor will be required to pretty much clean up. So let's see how this goes. And we're going over the station vessel list right now for this game. Great pick from the Murder Hornets, who uses a great advantage yesterday against the Sabreps. So let's see if they can do the same here tonight against 1AW. 1AW also still looking for their first win of the season, so they're hungry to try and come out hot here. So let's see how this match goes. Loading in now, and here comes 1AW. Docklight's leading them out. Thanks for the sub. Thanks for the sub booster.
Titan 2 in formation.
And here comes the Murder Hornets.
Eliminate all enemy starfighters in this system.
Thanks for the follow, Fuzzy. Okay, here they come now. Let's see who's leading out. I think with Psy Warriors in the front. That's Docklight. Docklight's in the front here. some mind cannons coming in now. They're going after Captain Obvious. Captain Obvious eyeing down Captain Obvious. Captain Obvious now needs to go full evasive. He's running around. Ghost to 12 is under heavy fire. Ghost to 12. Can they finish him off? Ghost still have a shield. This Starfire falling around. Ghost to 12 is at 20 hull. Repair kit off. But can Starfire finish? Fire gets the first kill of the game. Ghost to 12 goes down. Meanwhile, from the A-Wing side, let's see how Flabbergasted is looking. Flabbergasted trying to find his next target. Roxy is in his sights. Roxy has gotten another pick. Roxy will get two kills here so far. Going after Spaceman. Spaceman looking like an easy target, but maybe not. Oh, I've seen rockets flying. Jousting the defense, the bomber, and no, goes down Flabbergasted in a very bad joust. Very bad joust. There goes Starfire now, setting off her invisibility. Or his invisibility, excuse me. Starfire now looking at Psy Warrior. Psy Warrior trying to go evasive here. Oh, but Psy Warrior just trying to avoid the stall, getting on Spaceman. Has fire back on him. Spaceman looking hurt. Spaceman falls, and there goes the first kill for 1AW. Meanwhile, the Psy Warrior is in trouble from Captain Obvious. Captain Obvious picking up an easy kill with the stalling of the Psy Warrior. Captain Obvious now looking flabbergasted in his A-Wing. Flabbergasted, unaware, trying to pick up his own kill. Flabbergasted. Discounted. Flabbergasted trying to go after Veggie Booty. Veggie Booty now. Being chased, but here comes Captain Obvious. Yeah, I meant to say he, sorry. Captain Obvious, gets flabbergasted and down with flabbergasted. Another kill here for Murder Hornets. Murder Hornets up now 5-1. They're one away from picking up that critical extra bonus point. And if they've got to hold the lead now, Spaceman and an Iron Bomber. Iron Bomber, interesting call here. Typically you see that with a defender, but using the bomber's hull as an iron prevention from Y-Wings. I think they're probably expecting the Y-Wings. But not to be had. Oh, Cthulhu falls, another kill. Doc Weiss, meanwhile, is going full evasive from Captain Obvious. Roxy also on Doc Weiss. Roxy lining up. Oh, there's an Ion Interceptor. Interesting. Two Ions coming from that to try and preserve the Ion Dunks. Doc Weiss also taking fire again from Spaceman. Meanwhile, Starfire completely on a different target, goes to 12, and down goes go to 12. 7 points now for the Murder Hornets. While 1AW, oh, 8 points! Another kill from Starfire. Wow, Starfire lighting it up. See, Veggie Booty is in trouble now. Veggie Booty, oh, at the edge of the map, explodes, and two kills have come for 1AW. 1AW now trying to catch up. Roxy and Veggie Booty have fallen. Goes to 12, looking for the next target. Fine, Psy Warrior is also in, being chased. Cthulhu saves, trying to catch up and cover. 1AW now a little bit broken up here. Flabbergasted under heavy fire from Captain Obvious. Flabbergasted trying to get away. Does get away a little bit, but he'll need a peel. Goes to 12, trying to get on Captain Obvious for that peel. And Captain Obvious is going to get away, so they're going to change targets here. Nope, going back to Captain Obvious. Meanwhile, oh, another kill has come in on Spaceman. 1AW is starting to close the gap here. Starfire going after Cthulhu saves. 8-5 in favor of the Murder Hornets. By 9-5. Yes, 9-5. Ooh, maybe 10-5. 10-6 as Roxy falls. Psy Warrior. Oh, escapes. Great barrel roll. Great barrel roll from the Psy Warrior there with Psy Warrior. Trying to escape, but yep, definitely does here. Flabbergasted has fallen in the meantime. Murder Hornets trying to keep that 5-point lead. Remember, the 5-kill lead is important because it gives them the bonus point at the end. Starfire focusing heavily on Psy Warrior. Psy Warrior getting into the station. Psy Warrior gets another miraculous escape. And Psy Warrior pulled off. Starfighter putting heavy pressure on. Psy Warrior, oh, cannot break away. Starfire gets the kill and will be on Flabbergasted next and gets another kill. 13-6 in favor of the Murder Hornets. With 5 minutes gone and 10 minutes to go, Murder Hornets looking on pace for a 30 kill game here. Oh, another kill coming in. Great tag team from the Murder Hornets here. 1AW needs to take a deep breath here and just kind of regroup to make sure they don't get split up, because they are now starting to trickle in, and trickle in is very bad here for the dogfight as it makes for easy picks. Okay, all five in now. Meanwhile, the Murder Hornets looking for the next target. Their split up team goes to 12 and Flabbergasted, Spaceman, and Starfire on goes to 12. Goes to 12. Shieldless trying to get shields back. Starfire trying to pull in the laser. Starfire about to get another pick. Starfire does get another pick. Meanwhile, they also get flabbergasted. 1AW starting to fall into the trap of just being separated. Cthulhu saves, looking at Spaceman. Ooh, and we'll get that pick. Oh, but gets tagged up from behind. And they will give back the point they just gained. Captain Obvious taking heavy fire now. But we'll get their repair kit off the Side Warrior, trying to get a pick. Oh, Side Warrior gets dunked. Who had the dunk on? Looks like it was... Oh no, another kill. And the bad joust from Flabbergast. And Flabbergast getting torn up by the TIE Fighter, but this TIE Fighter now heavily damaged. Can they make their way there with Side Warrior and Blizzard 12? Need to have the recognition in order to go for it. Oh, on Veggie Booty. Nice dunk on Veggie Booty. And the Ram. Veggie Booty now. Oh, also gets the repair kit. So they're going to face the reset. Oh, Spaceman coming from behind on Ghost of 12. Flabbergast is on the other side of the map. Murder Hornets being very quick here, trying to get the 30 points as quickly as possible. Get another kill on Starfire, having the game of his life here. 16-1 right now. Fantastic work from Starfire, cleaning up the kills from the Disables and the Murder Hornets. Backlice will change start, visually change targets onto the Side Warrior. Dunk out on Side Warrior, but not enough. There's too much pressure coming on. Flabbergasted next target here. Flabbergasted trying to chase Roxy. Flabbergasted trying to get the kill on. Roxy doing a lot of dancing. She's doing a lot of dancing. She's got three. Oh, Flabbergasted gets peeled off. Meanwhile, Cthulhu saves. He's on Captain Obvious. 24-9 in favor of Murder Hornets. 8 minutes to go here. Moving very quickly through this. Cthulhu saves, trying to get after Captain Obvious. Meanwhile, Doc Lice is trying to go full evasive here. Let's find out from who. Probably Starfire. Yep, Starfire once again putting on the pressure. Starfire gonna get another kill! Another kill for Starfire. Murder Hornets are 5 points from victory here. 25-10 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Veggie Booty now trying to look for... Ooh, an ICT Y-Wing's out there. They're gonna change it up here, see if they can claw back in this match. It's not over. There's still plenty of time, and this is organized dogfight, so this can turn on a dime with the right chain competition. Ooh, Cthulhu saves, gets dunked by Veggie Booty. Veggie Booty will pick up the kill here. Captain Obvious now also on Ghost of 12. Nope, they're gonna chase the Flabbergasted. Flabbergasted trying to joust in on Captain Obvious with the rockets. Flabbergasted pulls off on the joust. Meanwhile, Roxy in her rotary bomber trying to work on Ghost of 12. Ghost of 12 is firing the ICT, trying to put pressure on the chasing ships. But no, down goes Ghost of 12 and Flabbergasted. So, looks like 2 points to go. 13 minutes have passed. One kill to go now with Doc Lice having fallen. Looks like it's down to Psy Warrior trying to hold it off. Gets dunked to Psy Warrior. So it's Veggie Booty. Yep, Veggie Booty gets it, and there it goes. The Murder Hornets win 30-11 in a very impressive showing on the Empire side. See that scoreboard there? Starfire picking up 2/3 of the kills, 20 of them with only one death. Impressive showing from the Murder Hornets and Starfire in particular. 1AW there, getting their kills in, working a little bit together, but they just were not able to be evasive enough to avoid the heavy fire of Starfire. So, 3 points to Murder Hornets, and we'll go on here to game two. Wow, what an exciting first match there. It looked like it was close there in the early goings, but then the Murder Hornets buckled down, made sure that they went together, focused their kills, and went after 1AW in very impressive fashion, going from a 5-point lead to quickly a 10-point lead, and then into a very impressive almost 20-point lead from the Murder Hornets. Great job from them. So, waiting here now for 1AW to set up the cast. I will need to look it up, Terrified. I am sure that it might be close to. I don't want to say that's true, though, because I know we've had earlier seasons where there were a bit of noise, but 20 kills from one person is pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. Okay, let me do this, guys. I'm going to pre-roll an ad because I don't want it to roll in the middle of you guys in the next match, so I'm going to roll a minute 30 ad, and then I'll be right back as soon as they get me the details. They'll be back in 90 seconds. Thank you. And welcome back, everyone. They just got the lobby up, waiting for the password right now, and then we'll jump in to watch game two here of this SPL matchup. Nope, that's not the password either. I need to get these guys the new modifiers, apparently. Give me a second, everyone. Book. Rule book. PL. Yep, you didn't know we changed the modifiers a little bit this season. We made it a little bit easier to kill the Empire. And what we thought would be a runaway with Imperial, with NR wins, it hasn't been that way. The bully ties have been very, very oppressive still. And good, sharp Imperial plays you saw in the last match led to very, very tight forays so far. So Empire hasn't lost a step this season. Apologize everyone, I'm trying to find the rules here. There it is. And I'm also waiting for the password for this. Give me a second here, everyone. Apologize for the delay in getting to this match. Still waiting for the password, everyone. But what I can do is this. Let's go here and I'm going to update the score line here since they're changing sides. Hornets. One. Yeah, I see a fuzzy. I don't know what's going on. They set up the room already. Yeah, I apologize everyone. They set up the room, but they haven't set the password out. Makes it hard to join. Oh, I guessed it. Yep, I got it too. Guessed it. Thanks for stopping by, man, Jackie. Thanks for stopping by. Glad you can see some of this match so far. God, I did it again. I'm sorry, everyone. Oh yeah, hard. This was the center. There we go. I'm gonna fix that later. Anyway, if you're just joining us, the Burn Hornets are taking on 1-8-W from Gray Squadron. Burn Hornets won the last match in convincing fashion. I think it was 30-11. So they're looking to complete the two-game set here. But 1-8-W is still looking for the first win of the season. And they would like to walk away here with a Empire split. Interesting to see how they line up. We didn't see the Wyoming ICT from 1-8-W, which is something that a couple teams have been running because of how present it can be. We're interested to see how the Murder Hornets come out. They did come out with multiple Y-Wings in the match last night against us. That's a great effect, so we'll see if they'll try it again tonight against here against 1-8-W. 1-8-W trying to see if they can come out with bully ties or if they have a mixed squadron like most others do. I am ready. So, coming in from the Murder Hornets, they're changing up now. The Roxy, Starfire, Mustang, Spaceman, and Fuzzy. A little bit of a change here. This was closer to the lineup they played last night against the Sabreps. Very strong lineup here. We're gonna definitely see some cohesion between Starfire, Roxings, and Mustang. And we'll see how Spaceman and Fuzzy will come in, as they're typically the support. Well, I don't want to say support players, but they're the trailers in the attack. So we'll see if they'll change it up here. Thank you. Alright, just waiting for 1AW to start this up. I've given them the green light to go. And then we will get to game two of this SPL match. Waiting now for these guys to start. There we go. Going into Gallatin. Interesting choice here from 1AW. Probably try and get some PEs, try and mix it up, try and cover away from the Y-Wings if they do come out. So it looks like it's gonna be bully ties across the board except for Doc Lice so far, but we'll see how that goes. Meanwhile, on the side, they'll come out with a very similar lineup to last night with two Y-Wings, two X-Wings, and the supports. Very good call here on NR, as the U-Wing is a much harder kill to pick up, and you get the resupplies in, so much longer ions out for the team, especially those ICTs. Plenty of disable should be coming in. We will see how they adapt. Yep, this will be an all bully tie. So this will be a pretty close matchup to last night, where Samro came out in five bully ties. Red Hornets came out in a mixed squad, but we'll see how they adjust in this match. Red Hornets still favored to win this match, but it might be a lot closer than the previous match was. 27 seconds to go, waiting for him with a lineup here. Let's just see what's up here on this side. Everyone facing away, very focused. Crew in the background, of course. There's the 3PO droid. Can't remember, is there a 3PO droid here? No, just the Imperial Station. Here we go. Gonna load into the asteroid field of Gallatin. High PEs usually in these kinds of matchups. We'll see if they can mitigate their mistakes, continue to draw the fire, or if they're going to try and drag it outside the asteroid field, and away from the crashing. And remember, there's no resupplies here, so mistakes will be punished heavily, heavily. They're putting in three Y-Wings. Interesting choice, especially on Gallatin, where the ICTs will be very limited. But we'll see how they do with this.
Titan two standing by.
Okay, here they come. Three
Ready for
Y-Wing and
a place
X-Wing
like
and a
this.
U-Wing against the five bully ties. Doc Lice goes to 12, looking for their first targets here. Starfire in their line of sight, not looking around for any other targets. They're trying to pick up Starfire. Doc Lice is trailing behind them. Gonna go after Fuzzy's cool kick. But already firing off that chaff. They're gonna. Oh, Spaceman's dunk. Spaceman's dunk. Well, they get the first blood here. No resupply out the Spaceman. Great job from Roxy getting that resupply out. Trying to keep Spaceman in his line of sight here. Now Starfire trying to line up the Plasma Burst against Booster. Booster trying to evade away. Booster trying to keep away from it. Oh, trying to get in front of it too now. Full call from Booster, especially with that Plasma Burst. As his resupply, will he use it first? Oh, crash from Booster. Crash, a death from Spaceman. They're tied 1-1 right now. Let's see where the Y-Wings are looking now. The Y-Wings are looking from the Psi Warrior with Psi Warrior 87 health. Trying to avoid. Oh, Mustang's getting chased. Mustang getting heavy fire. Two saves. Mustang shields are starting to come back up. The Y-Wings putting in their ICT. Oh, dunked, and there goes the ICTs. And then this should be a cleanup from Starfire. Oh no, the resupply out. Will they survive? Let's see if Starfire can stay on it. Starfire does get the kill. 3-1 to the NR so far, but Mustang will fall. 3-2 now in favor of the Murder Hornets, but this is a lot closer, as I said. Here comes Doc Lice. Doc Lice chasing after Starfire. Long ion, but Starfire getting caught out, trying to not crash. Another kill goes to Booster. Another death goes to Booster. So Murder Hornets are leading 4-2 here. Chasing now after Ghost of 12. Ghost of 12 has an iron arm. Ghost of 12. Evade. Spaceman's conversion shield is set off. Let's see where they're gonna get the. Oh! Dunk on Roxy! Dunk on Roxy! No, not dunk. No. Oh, yeah. Gee. Oh, Roxy Fox, heavy fire. 5-4 in favor of the Murder Hornets. It's very close here. Ghost of 12 now under heavy fire from Spaceman. Let's check Spaceman's view. Spaceman chasing after Ghost of 12. But Ghost of 12 will fall behind the rocks here, buying himself some space. Ghost of 12 evading. Another kill coming in from the Murder Hornets. The Murder Hornets now lead 6-4. Roxy running shields. She is running tax shields. That wasn't covered. That was Jackson. Oh, great dunk. Chunk. Chuck gets a dunk on Booster. Booster will fall 7-4 in favor of the Murder Hornets now. Looks like a side warrior trying to run away from Starfire. Check out Cthulhu saves. Cthulhu saves is closing on Fuzzy now. Cthulhu trying to get a dunk on Fuzzy. Trying to avoid the ICT fire. So Fuzzy's going to turn around and find a side warrior. Iron out and with Psy Warrior evading, and there goes the Iron missing. 7-5 still in favor of the Murder Hornets. Now they're going after Cthulhu Saves again. Cthulhu Saves trying to jump around and trying to go after Roxy. Roxy gets dunked. Oh, Doc Lice falls. Ghost of 12 looking at Roxy. Will not. Oh, maybe. There it goes. Roxy falls. Cthulhu Saves has fallen though. Ghost of 12 is under heavy fire now. Let's check where that fire is coming from. It's coming from Chuck, who has changed to an X-Wing. So they're now down only 2 Wyverns on the field. Roxy has fallen, but the Murder Hornets still lead 9-6 here. Chuck chasing after the Psy Warrior. Starfire going after Doc Lice instead. Doc Lice trying to put heavy pressure on Spaceman. Has to be careful. It gets blasted by Starfire. Starfire's impressive blast burst. Torching that TIE Interceptor. Doc Lice had a great look on the kill, but just couldn't finish it before getting roasted. Now Booster flying fast, trying to get out of Starfire's way. Has the resupply kit, but we'll use it, and we'll fall. He uses it too late. Meanwhile, Spaceman now trying to go after Cthulhu Saves, but he's taking heavy fire for Cthulhu Saves. No shield to reply. Oh, Cthulhu Saves pulls out at the last second, not finishing the kill. Let's see if Cthulhu Saves can come back around. Dunk to the Spaceman. Spaceman disabled here. And we'll fall 11-7 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Side Warrior now. Checking out on Chuck. Just trying to see if anyone else. Doc Lice will come in. Let's see if Doc Lice can finish off the kill here. Oh, trying to avoid Starfire. Starfire. 1000% hunting that interceptor. Roxy falls again. A fight to a Side Warrior. No, Cthulhu saves here. Chuck. Trying to avoid. A dunk here. Fuzzy's a cool kid, also trying to avoid a dunk here. As the entire team is looking at it, but Cthulhu Saves falls to probably Starfire's Starfire's Blast Burst. Well, 8 in favor of the Murder Hornets. It's all the Murder Hornets now as they go after a Psy Warrior. Starfire trying to follow up his 20 kill game here in this Blast Burst. Be very hard though, considering that it's harder to kill these bully ties. Looking around here. Solo out. Trying to dunk fire, but it's exploded in his own face here. No friendly fire, of course, so it'll be fine. Fuzzy's looking at Doc Lice as well. Looks like they're all trying to put a kill on Doc Lice. Doc Lice, ooh, Ryan has been avoiding it. So now, the other one after going after Ghost of 12. Ghost of 12 now trying to avoid heavy fire. 13-8 in favor of Murder Hornets. Murder Hornets now have the 5 kill advantage to get the bonus point. Oh, nope, they've lost it here as Mustang Chuck has fallen. 6 minutes have passed. Under 9 minutes to go. This is a much slower kill affair, but a much tighter affair here. 13-9 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Murder Hornets need one more to get back that bonus point. Go back here to 1AW. 1AW has a great pick on Roxy. Roxy now taking heavy fire. Roxy at 2. Oh, can Doc Lice finish? Oh, Doc Lice. Yes, and there's the kill. 13-10. 1AW clawing back here. Great job from 1AW. Oh, but Ion's heavily pouring into Ghost of 12 here. Meanwhile, Spaceman is hunting down Booster. Booster flying away, getting behind. Avoiding the goal and getting behind the rocks, buying himself some time. Fuzzy hunting Doc Lice. I'm sure Starfire is also on Doc Lice. No, Starfire is on a different target here. Under Cthulhu saves. Cthulhu saves at 3 health, gets the repair kit out. Cthulhu saves here, let's see. Knows that Starfire is on his 6. And Starfire finish it off. There's a iron out of Cthulhu saves Falls 14-11. Favor the Murder Hornets here. They need one more to get back to. No, they need two more to get back to that 5-point advantage. 1AW trying to close the gap here and bring up a tie. Trying to repeat what happened last night with the Murder Hornets and Sabret. Let's follow Doc Lice here. Doc Lice, oh, goes to 12, is on Roxy. Roxy lost the shields, but he's getting it back now. She's getting it back now, excuse me. Roxy takes a dunk and falls 15-12 as Booster had fallen at the same time. This is a very close affair. 3 points separates these two teams. And 1AW closed the gap here. Dunk on Spaceman. Dunk on Spaceman. Shieldless. And Psy Warrior finishes off. Psy Warrior closing and now rotating around, lining up the kill. And this should be it. And there it goes. 15-13 coming back. Oh, two kills between these two teams. A dunk on Cthulhu saves and roasted by the blast burst from Starfire. Let's look at the score really quickly. Starfire at 10 kills. He's on pace to repeat if he can get the momentum going here. He's after Doc Lice. This will be 11, and that will be 11. 17-13 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Murder Hornets getting back their advantage. Looks like Starfire is now starting to feel it. Going after Psy Warrior. Psy Warrior, meanwhile, he is going after Roxy. Starfire has to make sure that he stays evasive while putting the finishing touches on Roxy. Roxy, she's trying her best to get her shields up. Her shields back to third now. Balanced out with a look to the back. Ooh, seven. Sorry, I really wanted to find out. And there goes Roxy. 18-14 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Let's go back to Starfire. Starfire hunting who next? Oh, another kill. I don't know if Starfire got credit for that. 19-14, fair of the Murder Hornets here. They need... Nope, they're at the 5-point, the 5-point spread. A little bit over 5 minutes left. 10 minutes have passed. Close to 10 minutes have passed. We are 11 kills away from ending this match, but 1AW has shown that they are capable of coming back in this match now. So, oh! Roxy gets a disable with Psy Warrior. Psy Warrior will get away from that, though. Ooh, disable with the Ghost of 12. But they're putting pressure on Roxy now. Doc Lice trying not to get roasted. Psy Warrior gets the kill on Roxy. 20-15 as Ghost of 12 falls after the disable. Let's see what Fuzzy's up to here. Fuzzy going after Cthulhu saves. Fuzzy putting on laser fire now. 21-15, 6 kill spread for Murder Hornets with 5 minutes remaining. They will need 9 to close it away, or they can end it here. Let's look at the bonus point. Oh, Fuzzy's getting heavy fire here. Cthulhu saves and Booster are under heavy fire now. Starfire, let's follow. Starfire got dunked. Starfire taking heavy fire. Starfire boxed again. Starfire still getting the shields up, but with the repair kit out. He will survive. Doc Lice, meanwhile, trying to put pressure on Fuzzy's a cool kid. Fuzzy trying to go evasive, getting the shields up. Shields are almost back up to 200% here. Shields are back up. Oh, avoids the fire and gets the resupply from Roxy. Well done from Roxy. She's now looking at Doc Lice. 24-15, almost a 10-point spread now. The Murder Hornets are trying to pour it on. They want to win big here. Going another resupply to Fuzzy. Fuzzy getting a save. Meanwhile, Doc Lice is under heavy pressure, gets dunked, and will explode. 25-15 in favor of the Murder Hornets. 4 minutes to go. Let's check it really quick. Murder. Starfire needs 5 kills in order to match. Psy Warrior gets dunked. Will Starfire be there to pick up? Ooh, dunked on Starfire! Who's on Starfire now? Who can pick up Starfire? Oh, no help for Psy Warrior, who's able to get pressure off of Starfire, but no one was there to help clean up. Meanwhile, it looks like the team has decided that Fuzzy's a cool kid will be the main target to try and put away and get some points back. 26-15 with 3:30 to go. This will be close for the Murder Hornets. They have a little over 3 minutes to try and get the 4 more kills they need to close out the game. And Fuzzy falls 26-17 as it's now a 9-point spread in favor of the Murder Hornets. Let's look back to Murder Hornets here. Starfire, who's been the MVP of this series, is looking desperately for another kill. Mustang Chuck lining up someone in his path. Doc Lice, who's in a fully tied, gets lit up and ram, but will survive. Oh, and there goes Chuck. 27-18 in favor of the Murder Hornets still, as Ghost of 12 also falls. 3 kills to go, under 3 minutes to go here. Let's see what Roxy's up to. Roxy trying to go evasive, trying to fire stuff in space. Try to disable Psy Warrior. Meanwhile, back on the side, they get Roxy dumped, but no one is there to close. Doc Weiss is trying to put it away on Roxy, getting heavy ion pressure. Roxy at 10. Roxy trying to evade. Roxy will get the lizard. Nope, will knock the shields up. 27-19 in favor of the Murder Hornets. 1AW trying desperately to get back into this. They can close it out and try and get a bonus point just by getting under 5 kills. Mustang Chuck is trapped behind a rock. He's trying to avoid it. Wasai Warrior chasing. Wasai Warrior does not want to bonk in that. Here we go. 120 seconds left. 120 seconds left. Ooh, a bunch of targets in front. Looks like it's Chuck. Chuck is going full evasive. Chuck has attack shield in front of him. So he has a bit of a bonus. Oh, was there a disable out here? Can't find it. Sorry. And Chuck falls 20 to 28. They did get Doc Weiss in the meantime. A little bit over 90 seconds ago. It's actually 100 seconds right now. Murder Hornets only need 2 kills here to close it out. They are pushing on Cthulhu Saves and Psy Warrior. Let's see where they're at. Cthulhu Saves is running. Negotiations with Psy Warrior, it looks like. They get another kill on Booster. 1 kill left. Roxy falls 29-21 in favor of the Murder Hornets. Let's see who can get the final kill. 60 seconds, and that's it. And here comes Starfire to lead out the team as the Murder Hornets picks up 6 points tonight to go into, I believe, second place? No, they'll be in second place because they have 1 game ahead of us. Right, Saturday. Yeah, we'll be playing our 3rd game tomorrow. So with this 6-0 victory, Murder Hornets will move into the second. Oh, they might be first because I think Cutie Ties has only played 1 game. What a phenomenal match, and Starfire repeats the performance to go 20-0. 40 kills, 40 kills over 2 matches from Starfire. Fantastic work here. Roxy with 16 assists, even though she had 10 deaths. And great work from 1AW, goes to 12-4-2 with 12 assists. Good work there, and Psy Warrior 6-1. So not bad for 1AW. It was a great match. Murder Hornets just turned it on there at the end. And he's able to pull away with the win. Okay. SCL. There we go. Yes, trying to outdo the Cutie Ties this season, it looks like. Let me just get here. So, great work from both sides here. Murder Hornets picked up 6 critical points, as I said before, and they are looking to keep the pressure on if they can somehow get point advantage on the Cutie Ties. They could have a great shot here for any first or second. It'll be very tough though, because Cutie Ties are Cutie Ties. They fall a point behind the Sabrips, because Sabrips were able to get a 3-point victory against them. But if they get some help from Cutie Ties or Supports 5, Murder Hornets could be in the running for second place here. So this will be interesting to see how it plays out. Give me a couple minutes here. I'm going to see if they want to do an interview. If not, we might call the cast here. So give me a second here to figure out what is going on with these guys. God, these Likus aren't comfortable when you're sitting. Okay, I think Mustang Chuck will be joining me here for the interview. While we wait for that, let me look at the last couple games here. I don't think I put up stat padding is what it is. Stat padding. I think. So Cutie Ties have 6 points now. MH has 8 points, I believe. So, but Cutie Ties have a game in hand. Zavrap have 6. 9. No, wait, I'm doing this math wrong. Sorry, they have 6. They have 12 points, so Q-Tides has 12 points. Murder Hornets have 6. 8. 8 points. So, 12 to 8. And then the Savrips have 6. 9. 10. So, the Savrips are in second place with the, 12 points. Okay, so yeah, so I'm sorry, 16 points. So yeah, Murder Hornets are in the lead right now, but Savrip and Cutie Ties have a game in hand to catch up, essentially. Okay, looks like they'll be sending someone up here shortly. Did I capture it? No, I didn't capture it. Okay, I can always capture it by stream. They didn't get the screenshots from game one, which is not a big deal. Oh, there it goes. Okay, waiting for someone from Murder Hornets to join me here in the casting booth. We can get, and I get a little insight into what had happened in that game and the strategy behind it. So what'd you see? This was, even though, it was good to be Murder Hornets win. I think 1AW did a great job of seeing the match, and they did a great job of adjusting. Hey, Roxy and Mustang, how are you guys doing tonight?
Doing good. How you doing, man?
I am doing great. First off, congratulations on the big win. 6 points to you guys. You will be first place right now. I just did a little bit of math here. But Cutie Ties and Savrip will have a game in hand on you, so hopefully you guys can hold the lead here. So, to talk about tonight's game, let's look at your strategy for Empire. I noticed that you didn't try to shake it up from last night, so I guess you guys wanted to go with the same strategy that you had planned for last night's game. It's tonight's game, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one of the things we were talking about beforehand. I think Fuzzy kind of took some of the lead on that one because I tend to think I'm better as the Empire or as a New Republic pilot. Fuzzy, are you in here?
I am.
Do you feel comfortable talking about your guys' Empire strat?
So, you know, last night we were struggling a little bit. Well, on New Republic, but not so much on the Empire. So we had a strong Empire game last night. So we kind of just stuck with it. Threw some bully ties out there, have somebody fly and flex to do some annoyance. And whenever somebody dies, they evaluate the situation, see where we're strong and where we're weak, and kind of fill the gap.
Yeah, and it seemed that payoff. You guys didn't keep your foot off the gas, and I think the big story of tonight was Starfire. Starfire had 20 kills in game one and in game two, but some of game one first. Like, Starfire just was all over the place and seemed to just be picking up everyone's kills. So, I mean, was it intentional for you guys to set up Starfire, or did Starfire just have, like, this bloodlust in him?
I feel there was a bloodlust. I'll be real.
Yeah, Starfire's always been one of our top killers, one of our top PKers. So, yeah.
Yep. Starfire is well known for his cleanup.
On the board.
And I think it was interesting, especially because, I mean, with NR, with the Plasma Burst, you guys were able to take advantage of that. But, I mean, with the Empire game, it definitely was a cohesive effort of making sure dunks were coming in. I saw the Ion Bomber. That was an interesting call to try and keep Ions in the field. It seems to paid off for you guys tonight. I saw the Iron Interceptor as well, so you guys could conserve your Ion Missiles. I think that was a very bold strategy, and it paid off. So that Empire game, like I said, you guys ran away with it, and it seemed like a very clean effort from you guys on that, so it really was very good. But then switching to game two, you guys did come out hot. You guys did take an advantage early on, but it seemed like at first, at least for the first half of the match, 1AW stepped with you guys step to step. So what do you guys do to adjust in order to suddenly take a 10-point advantage late into the match?
Yeah, so we were talking about that beforehand. Is we were going to run something similar to what I think they ran yesterday, and kind of have somebody flex from Y wing to X wing if we felt it was needed. You know, if we felt that the strategy for the match called for it. I tend to feel like I'm better in my X wing than my Y wing, so I got to a point in the match where it's like, look, I'm not doing any good right now with my Y wing, so I'm going to jump into my X wing. And see if I can tip the scales back in our favor.
Yeah, and strategic deaths as well is another thing that we've been working on. Is when the support might be low on resupplies or completely out, just letting the support kill itself and Also, if you are low on auxiliaries and the support is busy with somebody else and the team's good, it might be worth just taking yourself out in a body blow or something like that to try to do some damage while getting your auxiliaries back up.
Yeah, I feel like the support kept the flow going.
Yeah, no, I was about to say, I think it was interesting. I mean, even though you had 10 deaths in the second game, Roxy, you were very active in the match, getting some disables, which I caught on stream, and keeping... You saved... there was a moment there where I was following Fuzzy, and you kept Fuzzy alive, especially when he was down to 30 health. So being able to still have the resupplies, you know, even though you showed 10 deaths, it didn't really matter because those deaths were reapplied back and keeping the rest of your team alive so they could keep pressure up. Especially because the Y-Wings late in the game were starting to take heavy pressure once 1AW realized they were struggling to kill the two X-Wings. Yeah, so you guys had a great match tonight. Graduations, again, it was very clinical from what we saw on stream. And I think you have one big match left against Cutie Ties, which everyone in the league at least is watching because it will be a very decisive match in how the playoffs stand, or the playoffs, how the championship stands. So hopefully you guys prep up and can do well. We face them on Saturday, so I think you, us, and Cutie Ties have some critical matches against each other, and hopefully you guys can have this strong performance again from last night tonight going into the Cutie Ties game.
We appreciate that, and once again, thanks to 1AW for a really good match. I know I can't speak for the first one because I wasn't in it, but in the second one, I haven't had a good match like that in a long time, so we appreciate the really good match that they gave us. They flew great. Some of them were just so hard to nail down that I was getting a little bit flustered here and there. GG's to 1AW. That was a really, really, really good match.
Oh, absolutely.
I had a great time.
Absolutely. Yeah. I would say that they, especially in their Empire game, I there was a point there I thought they were going to come back on you guys. But really credit to you guys at the second half of that NR game to adjust and then just come ahead and, you know, get a very decisive win. So, again, great job to you guys. Congrats. And good luck against Cutie Ties. We are all watching, and we do hope you pull off an upset there.
We appreciate it, man.
No problem, guys. Have a good night.
Y'all too.
Have a good night.
Bye-bye.
And to everyone on my stream, thank you for watching. This was an SCF production of the Squadrons Premier League Dogfighting. Tomorrow night, if you come back, the Zavrips will be taking on Support 5, and I think their first match. So if you're looking for an interesting matchup, Support 5 will be coming out with 5 supports against last season's second place team, the Zavrips. So please come back here. I'm not sure who's going to be casting it, so looking at that, but if not, I will be streaming it at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So with that, I bid everyone good night, and I will see you later. Have a good night, everyone.